As the state's land, sea, and space grant university, UNH has been fulfilling its mission of teaching, research, public service, and outreach for more than 100 years. I'm John Pike, Dean and Director of UNH Cooperative Extension, and I'd like to take a few minutes to tell you about our organization and its positive impact throughout the state of New Hampshire. Our educational efforts focus on the development of human potential, support the state's economy, and contribute to the sound development of the environment. The land grant, sea grant, and space grant university system around the country, and UNH in particular, have been responsible for advances in agricultural production, forest management, marine science, nutrition and food safety, as well as youth leadership. The mission of UNH Cooperative Extension is to provide New Hampshire citizens with research-based education and information. This mission helps people make informed decisions which strengthen youth and families, sustain natural resources, and improve the economy. UNH is the first part of our name, as the university provides the major research support base for our local programming. Cooperative refers to our cooperative arrangement between county, state, and federal levels. County commissioners and state legislators throughout New Hampshire work closely with our staff and volunteers on local county extension councils to provide support for cooperative extension work. Extension refers to the link between university-based research, extension educators, and the application of research by local citizens throughout the state. Our mandate to serve the people is embodied in the Smith-Lever Act of 1914. From its earliest years, the Smith-Lever Act focused on agricultural research. That role today not only includes agricultural research, but has expanded to research focused on families, communities, and businesses throughout our state. We're focusing on the sound development of our forests and lands, as well as improved water quality of our lakes, streams, and rivers. We're looking at enhancing sustainable agricultural systems. We're providing educational programs in nutrition and food safety, as well as fostering the self-esteem of youth, particularly youth at risk, and developing the full human potential of youth and families throughout New Hampshire's 234 towns and cities. A key component of UNH Cooperative Extension is to focus on the development of agricultural resources throughout the state. Experiments at UNH's own Woodman Farm lend a hand in extending the research of the university and has become an important backbone to the growing agricultural industry in the state.
They developed this orchard because they wanted us to have a laboratory where we could implement the practices aimed at absolute minimum spray intervention in a practical grower-sized field operation, if that makes sense. Now, what's the impact of that? The impact is that 20 years ago, if you looked at the typical commercial orchard, you would have seen somewhere between 11 and 13 fungicide sprays applied during the course of the growing season to control this disease, the single most important pest of apple in New Hampshire. If you look at this block here today, you're only looking at a total of 3 sprays a year. So from 11 to 13 to 3, the direct result of A, very good research on the biology of the pest and some innovative ways to manage the pest, primarily by Bill McCarty here at the University of New Hampshire, and an extension program directed by Alan Eaton and Bill McCarty and myself aimed at grower involvement and grower implementation of these practices in the field.
The fishing industry is faced with the reality of reduced fisheries and the development of rewarding new markets. UNH Cooperative Extension, in partnership with the Sea Grant College Program, works closely with the industry to meet these challenges.
It's a classic extension mission in that we take a problem from real people, bring it to the university, and use university resources. This is sort of the real extension model.
UNH Cooperative Sea Grant Program has made and developed the connections between the industry and the researchers and the university system, and the academic community has been just as satisfied to make the connection with the fishermen. I think without the interaction between them both, you're going to have people working in isolation without a development or without a smooth approach to a situation, to a problem, to a solution.
Most of New Hampshire's landscape consists of forested land. Good stewardship through extension programs helps to encourage the development of raw materials for the state's $1.7 billion forest industry. Natural resources also provide the backdrop for New Hampshire's number one industry, tourism. Our forestry and wildlife program has two very important partnerships. Since 1985, the New Hampshire Fish and Game Department has funded the Extension Wildlife Program, and since 1925, we've been caring for New Hampshire's forests in partnership with the New Hampshire Division of Forests and Lands. Cooperative Extension is an essential part of the university, providing outreach to the citizens of New Hampshire. We've created a number of tools to show the diversity of plants and animals that we have in the Granite State, the pressures that face them, such as development and population growth, the importance that they are to each of us and to future generations. Environmental monitoring programs are important to sustaining and balancing development. Our Lake Slay Monitoring Program, a joint program with the university's Freshwater Biology Group and its analytical lab, play an important role in a neighbor-to-neighbor approach for the protection of watersheds throughout the state. County Extension educators work with private landowners, communities, and conservation groups to help accomplish permanent, voluntary land conservation and are involved with a broad spectrum of conservation and policy issues related to land, forests, and water.
One of the emphasis that I've been trying to get communities to think about is inventorying natural resources, really what's the key and important natural resource features that they have left in their communities, getting them to identify them, to inventory them, and then work toward protection of them for the long haul. We try to get towns to think about big blocks of open space. We try to get towns to think about farmland, which statewide now is getting to be a critical natural resource. Less than 10% of the state is now what we would consider a farmland resource. We also have very little undeveloped frontage on some of our major rivers, great ponds, and lakes. So these are, just in a nutshell, some of the features that we try to get towns to look at and inventory and think about protection.
UNH, the Youth Development Program of UNH Cooperative Extension, provides positive experiences for youth to develop their individual potential as caring and contributing members of an ever-changing world. Adult volunteers help 4-H participants become creative and productive citizens, foster self-esteem, and build leadership potential. A good example of the 4-H program is the New Hampshire State 4-H Teen Conference, held each year on the UNH campus. This event gives teens an opportunity to explore the university and build on their leadership skills.
Helping youth and families develop self-esteem and strong parenting skills are key dimensions of our family development programs.
Sometimes it's lonely being a single parent. It's also scary out there. It's scary for the kids. It's scary for parents. It's given them the self-esteem they've needed. It's given them skills that they can live with for the rest of their life. And these kids are going to grow up and they're going to do something as adults. They're not going to grow up there and rob banks. They're not going to grow up there and be losers. Now, not every kid's going to do this. But if you don't do anything, then you are going to have all these kids losers and not productive in life. You have something like this. You keep working at it as hard as it is and you drum away. You're going to have winners. And even if you only get 3 winners out of 10, at least you have 3 winners. You don't have all 10 losers. I have got 4 winners in my house because of this program.
UNH Cooperative Extension has a network of professional extension staff located in New Hampshire's 10 counties and on the UNH campus to design and deliver our educational programs.
We have a real emphasis on community development and really strengthening communities that people are living in. And a real good example of that is an initiative we have that's called the Community Profile Process. And the beauty of this is that it's actually citizens who are taking part in this. This isn't a group of government workers who are coming in and doing an assessment of the community and then informing the community of what it needs. These are the people who actually live in the community and come together. And all we do from the standpoint of the University of New Hampshire is facilitate the process.
For more than 80 years, UNH Cooperative Extension has been regarded as a trusted and effective educational resource for local citizens throughout the state of New Hampshire. We intend to build on that legacy as we continue to meet the non-formal educational needs of people throughout the state. As the state's land, sea, and space grant university, UNH has been fulfilling its mission of teaching, research, public service, and outreach for more than 100 years. I'm John Pike, Dean and Director of UNH Cooperative Extension, and I'd like to take a few minutes to tell you about our organization and its positive impact throughout the state of New Hampshire. Our educational efforts focus on the development of human potential, support the state's economy, and contribute to the sound development of the environment. The land grant, sea grant, and space grant university system around the country, and UNH in particular, have been responsible for advances in agricultural production, forest management, marine science, nutrition and food safety, as well as youth leadership. The mission of UNH Cooperative Extension is to provide New Hampshire citizens with research-based education and information. This mission helps people make informed decisions which strengthen youth and families, sustain natural resources, and improve the economy. UNH is the first part of our name, as the university provides the major research support base for our local programming. Cooperative refers to our cooperative arrangement between county, state, and federal levels. County commissioners and state legislators throughout New Hampshire work closely with our staff and volunteers on local county extension councils to provide support for cooperative extension work. Extension refers to the link between university-based research, extension educators, and the application of research by local citizens throughout the state. Our mandate to serve the people is embodied in the Smith-Lever Act of 1914. From its earliest years, the Smith-Lever Act focused on agricultural research. That role today not only includes agricultural research, but has expanded to research focused on families, communities, and businesses throughout our state. We're focusing on the sound development of our forests and lands, as well as improved water quality of our lakes, streams, and rivers. We're looking at enhancing sustainable agricultural systems. We're providing educational programs in nutrition and food safety, as well as fostering the self-esteem of youth, particularly youth at risk, and developing the full human potential of youth and families throughout New Hampshire's 234 towns and cities. A key component of UNH Cooperative Extension is to focus on the development of agricultural resources throughout the state. Experiments at UNH's own Woodman Farm lend a hand in extending the research of the university and has become an important backbone to the growing agricultural industry in the state.
They developed this orchard because they wanted us to have a laboratory where we could implement the practices aimed at absolute minimum spray intervention in a practical grower-sized field operation, if that makes sense. Now, what's the impact of that? The impact is that 20 years ago, if you looked at the typical commercial orchard, you would have seen somewhere between 11 and 13 fungicide sprays applied during the course of the growing season to control this disease, the single most important pest of apple in New Hampshire. If you look at this block here today, you're only looking at a total of 3 sprays a year. So from 11 to 13 to 3, the direct result of A, very good research on the biology of the pest and some innovative ways to manage the pest, primarily by Bill McCarty here at the University of New Hampshire, and an extension program directed by Alan Eaton and Bill McCarty and myself, aimed at grower involvement and grower implementation of these practices in the field.
The fishing industry is faced with the reality of reduced fisheries and the development of rewarding new markets. UNH Cooperative Extension, in partnership with the Sea Grant College Program, works closely with the industry to meet these challenges.
It's a classic extension mission in that we take a problem from real people, bring it to the university, and use university resources. This is sort of the real extension model.
UNH Cooperative Sea Grant Program has made and developed the connections between the industry and the researchers and the university system, and the academic community has been just as satisfied to make the connection with the fishermen. I think without the interaction between them both, you're going to have people working in isolation without a development or without a smooth approach to a situation, to a problem, to a solution.
Most of New Hampshire's landscape consists of forested land. Good stewardship through extension programs helps to encourage the development of raw materials for the state's $1.7 billion forest industry. Natural resources also provide the backdrop for New Hampshire's number one industry, tourism. Our forestry and wildlife program has two very important partnerships. Since 1985, the New Hampshire Fish and Game Department has funded the Extension Wildlife Program. And since 1925, we've been caring for New Hampshire's forests in partnership with the New Hampshire Division of Forests and Lands. Cooperative Extension is an essential part of the university, providing outreach to the citizens of New Hampshire. We've created a number of tools to show the diversity of plants and animals that we have in the Granite State, the pressures that face them, such as development and population growth, the importance that they are to each of us and to future generations. Environmental monitoring programs are important to sustaining and balancing development. Our Lakes Lay Monitoring Program, a joint program with the university's Freshwater Biology Group and its analytical lab, play an important role in a neighbor-to-neighbor approach for the protection of watersheds throughout the state. County Extension educators work with private landowners, communities, and conservation groups to help accomplish permanent, voluntary land conservation and are involved with a broad spectrum of conservation and policy issues related to land, forests, and water.
One of the emphasis that I've been trying to get communities to think about is inventorying natural resources, really what's the key and important natural resource features that they have left in their communities, getting them to identify them, to inventory them, and then work toward protection of them for the long haul. We try to get towns to think about big blocks of open space. We try to get towns to think about farmland, which statewide now is getting to be a critical natural resource. Less than 10% of the state is now what we would consider a farmland resource. We also have very little undeveloped frontage on some of our major rivers, great ponds, and lakes. So these are, just in a nutshell, some of the features that we try to get towns to look at and inventory and think about protection.
UNH, the Youth Development Program of UNH Cooperative Extension, provides positive experiences for youth to develop their individual potential as caring and contributing members of an ever-changing world. Adult volunteers help 4-H participants become creative and productive citizens, foster self-esteem, and build leadership potential. A good example of the 4-H program is the New Hampshire State 4-H Teen Conference, held each year on the UNH campus. This event gives teens an opportunity to explore the university and build on their leadership skills.
Helping youth and families develop self-esteem and strong parenting skills are key dimensions of our family development programs.
Sometimes it's lonely being a single parent. It's also scary out there. It's scary for the kids. It's scary for parents. It's given them the self-esteem they've needed. It's given them skills that they can live with for the rest of their life. And these kids are going to grow up and they're going to do something as adults. They're not going to grow up there and rob banks. They're not going to grow up there and be losers. Now, not every kid's going to do this. But if you don't do anything, then you are going to have all these kids losers and not productive in life. You have something like this. You keep working at it as hard as it is and you drum away. You're going to have winners. And even if you only get 3 winners out of 10, at least you have 3 winners. You don't have all 10 losers. I have got 4 winners in my house because of this program.
UNH Cooperative Extension has a network of professional extension staff located in New Hampshire's 10 counties and on the UNH campus to design and deliver our educational programs.
We have a real emphasis on community development and really strengthening communities that people are living in. And a real good example of that is an initiative we have that's called the Community Profile Process. And the beauty of this is that it's actually citizens who are taking part in this. This isn't a group of government workers who are coming in and doing an assessment of the community and then informing the community of what it needs. These are the people who actually live in the community and come together. And all we do from the standpoint of the University of New Hampshire is facilitate the process.
For more than 80 years, UNH Cooperative Extension has been regarded as a trusted and effective educational resource for local citizens throughout the state of New Hampshire. We intend to build on that legacy as we continue to meet the non-formal educational needs of people throughout the state